And overall, Elements, yeah, as you said, not going too well.
Well, hopefully they can bring it back around here, but H2K will be a tough opponent to start things off. Take a look at that first ban off the board. Looks like it's going to be Rek'Sai. We're on the other side, Elements. You can tell they're definitely taking their time about this. I think they want to slow this one down a little bit.
And I am checking in the game where we are, and it's a little slow on the bans here. A bit of a graphical error. Just want to repeat for the viewers that are watching outside. Blue team H2K just banned Urgot and Alistar. Elements reacted with Ryze and Maokai. We'll fix that promptly. Just keep those viewers reminded. Good Ryze purple ban. We've seen this before. Target ban on Oduwamna's Maokai, which he did great as well.
LeBlanc also banned away. So again, just to keep you guys up to date, since the bans are not showing up the way they're meant to. Urgot, Alistar, LeBlanc now all banned away by H2K. Not too many surprises there. We can talk about why in just a minute. There we go. We're going to see it crop up properly. And of course, on the side of Elements, it's Ryze, it's Maokai, and the last ban is Kalista.
Yeah, I think Kjarnr went big on that pick yesterday, if I recall correctly, where he had the Runan snowball going on, if that was indeed him. And early pickup Thresh here. Alistar's out of the equation as H2K banned themselves.
H2K did this as well, previous game, picking up that Thresh first, I think it was yesterday. Really prizing that, but this opens up some opportunities for Elements. They go ahead and snag the Gnar for themselves for JWoww, and Dexter gets a very top-tier jungler in that Gragas.
Yeah, Dexter on Gragas is something now I want to see. What can Dexter achieve with this pick? Can he translate that aggression in the right lanes for Elite for Elements? And is JWoww going to get some help this game?
Is JWoww going to get some help? We'll have to see. It was a bit of a rough game for him yesterday in that loss to Giants. 3-6-4, not the worst score of his team, but he didn't really get much help, as you mentioned earlier, off the desk on that Sejuani that Dexter had. We'll see if he's doing a little bit of a different tune there on that Gragas. Now, H2K, they lock in the Rek'Sai for themselves. They also go ahead and pick up Oduwamne's Rumble.
Yeah, did fantastic with Rumble yesterday as well. Got into the lane, so got behind, but got rolling, and eventually he was reducing 50 magic resistance of his opponents. At that point, nobody even had that much MR to deal with him.
Doing true damage.
Doing literally true damage in magic damage. And then Lulex picking up the Rek'Sai. I think he actually favors it over Gragas, so he won't be too fazed that Dexter took away that one.
Yeah, I don't think so at all. And for Elements on their camp, they're going to go ahead and pick up their duo lane down bot. Tabs and Promiscue will have the Janna, and they will have the Lucian. Some Fleet Feet there down in the bottom. We'll see what H2K answer with. They still need Yarnin's choice. And of course, Froggen, that last pick, he's going to have to take it blind, though.
He'll definitely have to blind pick it into... or Ryu will have to blind pick his mid lane into Froggen, or rather. And maybe Froggen can get that counter pick so he can start getting rolling, get a little better, get a little momentum, because last game that he played didn't look strong at all. Died a lot, and Pinera had the better of him.
Yeah, he's been having a little bit of trouble with these assassins dealing with him, and I think this is why they want to save it till last. But we'll see if Ryu goes a completely different path with that blind pick that he has. The Orianna, it had some mixed success for him in the previous split. They were able to wombo combo up a few times, and they're going to look to try and do it again here.
Yeah, H2K, this composition fits the style that we outlined for H2K start at the split when we went back to look at Spring Split. This 10 to 20 minute objective focused kind of style. Group with Sivir, engage with Rumble ulti, use the Orianna for zone control to pace around that objective and then get in there, potentially kill somebody, pick somebody off, and if not, secure that objective. It's definitely something H2K will be looking for. Elements, they have the double disengage with Gragas ulti. They have the Janna for disengage. Ring Gangplank, assuming not getting picked.
His supports do love their hovers.
Yeah, we do. We do love our attention. Sometimes people forget that we exist, so we do the Gangplank hover, the Teemo hover.
Just to make sure people start sweating a little bit if you're not paying attention.
Exactly.
Let's see what Elements do decide to go with at the end of it all. So, what will Froggen choose to answer? It is going to be a Kassadin. Interesting choice.
Not a fan of this because it's, again, low on wave clear, which reduces the tempo, which gives you another passive early game. And do you really want to play passive Elements? Last week you got one kill, two deaths in the first 15 minutes in both games combined. You're playing as a team that is notorious for playing passive the first 10 minutes, but then getting their foot on the pedal and getting many, many objectives in that 10 to 20 minute mark.
Absolutely. And Elements, you look at, compare them to yesterday with H2K, and it was almost the exact opposite story. Elements pretty much got rolled over by Giants. They really didn't have much of a lead most of the game. Or really, they were down considerably, and it just kind of got worse and worse and worse. On H2K's side, against Gambit, the exact opposite. They got a lead, they kept it, they kept moving forward, they didn't give an inch. Yes, Elements is a much safer team, but if they don't do anything in that early game, that'll open up H2K to really take it to them as coaches shake their hands and walk off the stage.
And once they start falling behind, if they fall behind, it'll be incredibly rough to get back in, because I don't think there's any targeted CC on Elements' side for a guaranteed lockdown. In addition to their fighting against the Sivir with Spell Shield and On the Hunt, that added mobility, those extra shields from Orianna coming out later as well, shield on Rumble 2, Lantern a bit of a shield on Thresh 2, so a lot of defensive tools on H2K's side.
Very many defensive tools indeed for H2K. They can play passive if they want, but I have a feeling it might be a little bit different. Why don't you guys go ahead and share your feelings with us, however. Go ahead and tweet us at LL Esports. H2K win, EL win, one of the two will be your option as we go onto the board to start the game. H2K versus Elements.
Both teams, casual walk out of the base. See if we see any invading shenanigans. Jana Lucian, pretty solid lane in 2v2. It's incredibly hard to spell shield the Lucian Q correctly. Just add a little Janna AD stereo to that and you will get eventually poked out. Tabs is a good AD carry, fantastic Lucian player as well.
Mm-hmm. But on the other hand, you've got H2K's bot lane that have a reputation for really liking that level 2 all in. It was something that Kasing brought to the team when he joined last spring after week 3. And Yharnam has kind of stepped up in that role. He's become a lot more of a damage threat as we see JWoww wandering right into the Flamespitter. I don't think he expected this many members of H2K there. He's going to have to burn his flash as Kasing's hook goes a little bit too
close though for
comfort. Yes, he's got some backup. Froggen might be leaving him on his own though. Can JWoww make his escape through the jungle? This is not the way you want to start. And the boomerang blade, not enough, but another flash from Odoamne. And first blood, a minute 15.
JWoww taken down immediately, oversteps his boundaries. A nice cheeky little play from H2K. They fake out the normal fan out, but then they send Hjarnan around the corner once they realized that JWoww was out of position. I think H2K was setting up for a lane swap, as we said earlier. Odoamne did well yesterday in the lane swap. Sivir Thresh probably wants a safer laning phase. But once they realized JWoww was a little far out, they forced his flash, chased him down, and no support from Elements, and again, no CC. Can't stop that.
Won't somebody help JWoww this game? We'll have to find out. Double lane swap actually coming in. So you have Tabs and Promise Q making their way up top. Tabs is already there, but they are going to meet Yharnam and Kasing. See if that is not what they were hoping to see, as JWoww and Dexter are going to be dueling up on the blue Sentinel. Lulex down at his own, and Promise Q is going to run right and smack dab into Kasing and Yharnam. You're not going anywhere. Get back in the hook. Promise Q's going down. Yharnam starts out with a kill. That's not what you want if you're Elements.
That was a really good hook from Kasing. He gets Promise Q right before he gets to the wall, and even if he flashes over, that hook would have followed straight through and potentially got Promise Q if he flashed over. Got him right in time before Promise Q could escape, and a good collapse. Saw him coming, punished him, and Elements down 2-0 with a passive mid laner, Kassadin. They're winning bot lane 2v2 matchup, but behind because Janna just had the base, and bot lane being pushed in as well. Things are not looking great.
No, especially not for this duo lane up in the top side. Tabs is going to have some trouble getting farm, especially considering that they should have had a pretty solid start. Lucian is generally a strong laner all the same. Yharnam, I guess, as well. But we'll have to see more as that one develops. The mid lane, don't expect to be a whole lot of action until that level 6 with Froggen, but you know, you expressed some concerns about that, and we got to keep an eye on that mid lane to see how it unfolds. Froggen has not really been himself, I would say, several months from now.
Yeah, I could definitely say that. Touching on that mid lane matchup, you could argue that Kassadin gets a free laning phase, but then the counter argument is that Orianna also gets a free laning phase to scale. Dexter hopped over the Baron wall here, avoids that ward is being placed, and he might find an opening here in this Janna Lucian matchup.
That man's on a secret mission, seeing if they can bait Yharnam and Kasing. He will come up here. The flash forward with the Janna Tornado means Yharnam is going to be the one targeted out. Dexter moving forward, and he just needs an auto attack, but they give it over to Tabs. Kasing now, belly bumped up. Tabs dashing forward, the barrel knocking him again, and he looks like he's about to go down. It's Promise Q with the Tornado to finish it off.
And this time, Dexter is right to gank for his bot lane, because if we go back to the level 1, Tabs, or Yharnam rather, used his flash offensively to secure that first blood, gets punished for that. good pathing from Dexter, uses his Gragas body slam to his advantage, gets over the Baron wall, dodges the ward. H2K lulled into this false sense of security and fantastic punish by Elements.
And just like that, the early game mistakes that Elements have made have been completely negated. H2K will have to be a bit more careful up in the top as long as Dexter is on the prowl. Yharnam now back into the lane. We'll mop up that farm. Let's take a look at where we are across the map. However, as we mentioned, it's definitely been a very quiet affair in the middle between Froggen and Ryu. The bottom lane, well, about as you could expect a Gnar and Rumble matchup to go. But Uwamne just continues to throw out the Flame Spitter and try to find anywhere he can maybe add a little bit of damage onto JWoww, but Dexter now is in that area.
Now this lane is pushing back in the bot lane towards Uwamne. He's already 5 CS or 4 CS ahead, and he has a lot more creeps to his disposal. So it looks like he's getting a bit of a CS lead hot here in the bottom lane. Dexter cleaning out the Skull Crab.
He's going to run into Lulex, though, or Lulex is about to run into him. He backs off the Crab, dodges the Prey Seeker, but now Lulex has a chance to pick this one up. Uncontested, pings are flying. Both junglers want to make sure everybody knows where they are.
That Skull Crab helps a lot, especially when you're freezing down a bot lane. JWoww is forced to base here while his lane is frozen, and he'll have to TP back, otherwise he will get denied way too much XP, leading to a potential teleport advantage for Uwamne coming up soon.
Mm-hmm. Froggen takes the QW combo from the Orianna. JWoww now spends his teleport, as you mentioned. Of course, he is close to that dragon side with the duo lanes up in the top. Kasing goes on a bit of a roam himself, actually, though, and he puts down the pink ward. Dexter might run right into that one as he gets pinged out by H2K.
And that vision keeps Ryu safe in the mid lane. Froggen with some CC. Oh.
Maybe not quite safe enough, but Lulex will go back in. They realize Promise Q's here. Had to back out. Not going to win that when you do not have the number advantage. So Elements shoring up their defenses as well, and even getting a little bit of damage out on H2K.
And as expected, very even passive mid lane matchup, trading a little bit back and forth, but no all-in potential on either side unless the junglers join the fray. Electros flashes down, Lulex hasn't found an opening either, so even CS in that mid lane.
Very, very even is the way to describe this opener. And we really expected this one, going back to Champ Select, just typically what we know of Elements, what they locked in, no surprises for them, so they really have doubled down on this strategy. Against a team like H2K, if you don't make mistakes, I suppose you can't be punished, but you know, what are the downsides to this one, Crepo?
Yeah, the downsides of this composition are obviously the low amount of wave clear and general pressure, but Dexter counteracted that a little bit. He's the only one that can make things happen in the early game, and he found himself 2 kills already. Didn't fall bait to the wards that Kasing plays, so he's having a very good early game. And he will definitely need to start snowballing this this top lane matchup, this bot lane matchup. He needs to be everywhere. Elements want Dexter to gank on every single lane, whether it's pressure, whether it's just helping get secure in the kills. Mm-hmm. It'll be hard now. Jarnus Flash came back up.
So he is, as a result, a little bit more of a tricky target to try and track down. Tabs and Promise Q, though, are dealing quite well, keeping even in the CS. You take a look at those items, of course, just the double long swords over for Yharnam versus the pickaxe. It's a little bit harder for Yharnam to trade at the minute, and Tabs is having a good time with it.
Yeah, luckily for H2K, Tabs did not get a BF sword on his first base, so he's stuck on that pickaxe, prolonging how long it takes for him to get that BF sword, so that poke from Janna's shield and Lucian Q will do a little less damage, but Yharnam is still in a somewhat comfortable position. This lane going even, and that's fine. Sivir wants to go even in this lane. Even CS is fine because she adds way more utility to the groups that H2K will do later to get those infamous H2K objectives.
Mm-hmm. Now we see Uwamne. After his back, he's coming back into lane. He manages to pick himself up that needlessly large rod. I really want to see, as the calling goes out from Tabs there, Yharnam and spell shields a bit of it. What happens with Uwamne this game? Because you mentioned last time his scoreline, 7-2-6. This is a guy that's known for doing the most damage per share as a top laner. He really likes to personify that top carry style and contribute as much as he possibly can. I want to see how he develops across this game and what Elements can really do to stop this. I mean, right now, you see that CS disparity already, and that Gnar is not going to have a good time dealing with the needlessly large Rod Uwamne to start things off.
Yeah, JWoww definitely stuck in a rough position. Had to use his flash level 1, still died. And look at that bottom lane, we're a bit frozen there. Already that CS advantage you were talking about. A little bit of aggro on the top lane. Lulex heading top 2.
And so is Froggen and Dexter, though. Oh, there we go. Prey Seeker wide. Have to bail out of that. Lulex knows it's not going to be as easy as 1-2-3. So, looks like the combination of Tabs and Promise Q have now shoved Yharnam and Kasing in just a little bit, but all the focus is towards this top side. Lulex, he pops the ward in the brush. It's spotted by the ping, but Tabs and Promise Q know something is up. And you can see everyone just keeps taking an eye up there.
And this just goes back to the point you made earlier, Pyra, about Odawanna being able to carry, because all the action is in the top side of the map, and Odawanna is just fine playing on the island, using that needlessly large ult to his advantage. Ulti comes out from Ryu, but we said this before, no all-in potential. Both champions will just poke each other out slowly. If there's no jungle interaction, this lane will just go even. You can see us 78 to 72 in the mid lane right now.
Mm-hmm. And, you know, pretty much that's the question that's got to be in Frog and Ryo's minds. When are we going to start seeing this gank, counter gank really start to take effect? We've seen a couple attempts. Dexter's made his move a few times. Ulix has been a little bit more top focused all over the map a little bit. But it is a very safe lane, and I feel like those two will have a much greater part to play come the team fights that, you know, will naturally occur the longer this game goes on, just with the compositions we've got here.
Yeah, now at this point, Sivir hitting level 6 with Spell Shield, with Summoner Heal, with Summoner Flash, and on the hunt. Incredibly hard lane to gank, especially since there's no offensive potential or very little offensive potential on that Janna. Asking the question again, when is Dexter going to help JWoww, or who's going to help JWoww, because he's down 20-30 CS now in this matchup. Odawanna scaling very well for those mid-game objectives.
Yeah, he really hasn't had much of a chance.
Look
right
at
now.
The gold discrepancy there, Pyra.
That is massive difference here. Finally, Dexter's going to be on the bottom side as JWoww starts to push back the waves from under the tower, but there's also Lulex here, and this is just going to be such a rough time for JWoww if he gets baited into this. His Mega Narvar is getting pretty close to fruition, though. He puts down the ward. He knew something was up, smelled it out. Still has to play it out safe, though.
And that's the problem. Once this matchup goes a little bit too far in one side, you always have to run the risk of finding the enemy jungler in that rush and then indicating that you're going to lose a 2v2. Teleport, though.
On the hunt as well. Yharnam spell shields the Janna Tornado. In comes Odawanna, throws down the Equalizer. Tabs and Promiscue both force suspend Flash, and a teleport canceled by JWoww.
Good cancel by JWoww. This is exactly what he needs. Some breathing room at the cost of two flashes on elements. Dexter's poison mid, though.
Yep, and Froggen is the one that takes a shockwave, but Ryu is the one that gets knocked back the wrong direction, and Froggen will pick him up with the help of Dexter.
Fantastic combo by Dexter that leaves Ryu no chance to reply with his flash of his own. In reaction to that, tower on the top lane falls. JWoww hitting the bot lane, but Lulex shows up there, so he's going to stop that.
Yeah, and Tabs is down here in the mid lane as well.
Good rotation.
Yeah, it was a really nice move by both teams, actually, after all of the action culminated in that one pickup on Ryu. Odawanna now moving into the mid. Froggen, Hosta backing away. Element should not have this tower. They do not have the wave,
don't,
and Odawanna is flashing. That is a ballsy move, and he nearly burns him down. Dexter's there, but so is Lulex, and he turns it on again. There's the Monsoon. What's stronger? The Flame Spinner is, and Lulex will pick up the kill. Hook flying, doesn't land on Dexter. Odawanna, this guy, this damage, he knows he's done. Dexter is cooked, and he is well done.
Odawanna with the blaze, flashes in for the Harpoon, knows that he can roast Tabs, or at least buy enough time for Lulex to follow. Prevents the body slam over the wall from Dexter, too. Fantastic play. We saw it yesterday. He carried without resources, and this time he has resources. 2-0-1. Needlessly large rod. Teleport to burn two flashes. Roams into the mid lane. Fantastic play by Odawanna.
And look at this adaptation that Elements are trying to do. A Hex Drinker on JWoww as his first completed item. You know you're in a little bit of trouble when that's what you have to get.
Yeah, JWoww struggling to stay afloat in this game. He thinks to himself, finally I get some breathing room. My opponent leaves this lane. He teleports out. Finally, I'll be able to survive. But then he comes back with a Zhonya's Hourglass finished at the 12-minute, 45-second mark. Odawanna, what have you been eating for breakfast later? And can I have some?
I think that's the question on a lot of people's minds, not the least of which are Elements right now. So taking stock of where we are in this game, 13 minutes have elapsed. Slim lead, well, not that slim. It's 1,500 for H2K. No dragons have hit play yet, but two towers taken down. And a whole heaping helping of action across the board as H2K hold that kill advantage 4-3. Dexter and JWoww, Meganar rapidly fading up in the top. Odawanna, though,
use this flash
try to spend time on him.
No flash on Odawanna right now. See if he plays passive or the snowball has gotten to his head. He's got
he really wants that pink ward, but he knows something's up. Instead, he goes back to the farm. and see if he can get out of this one. JWoww and Dexter pop out the brush. Dexter waiting to try and body slam him. He actually uses his explosive cast. Oduwane equalizers down, but he won't last that much longer as he turns on the flame spinner. Zhonya's looks for JWoww, realizes he's not got the damage, but Lulex back up. Here comes the cavalry, and the fat man is going down.
The cavalry arrived. That Zhonya's hourglass bought him enough time, but action on the bot lane.
Kasing puts the box down, and him and Yharnam will make it out alive. But they are a bit battered and bruised. Speaking of which, so are Tabs and Promise Q. Elements just not enough to get kills on the board.
Yeah, the right ID for the Elements lineup right here, trying to shut Oduwane down, but the Zhonya's Hourglass that he just finished allowed him to buy enough time for Lulex to come in. Immediately when that fight started, Lulex teleported through the closest tunnel, told Oduwane, just hang in there, buddy, just a couple more seconds. He arrived, as you said, cavalry came in, and they turned that around.
Yeah, and that's on his Hourglass, you know. Talk about a valuable item this early on in the game to be able to acquire. That really saved his life. On top of his moving around the positioning, he's able to pick up a Haunting Guys now as well. Talk about a snowball effect. This guy is getting big.
At this point, you might as well just ignore him. Try to snowball the other side of the map, but how are you going to do that? Froggen is still scaling. The bot lane is incredibly hard to gank with the Lantern to save Yharnam. Spell Shield 2, Flash Seal up. Where is Dexter going to find an opening?
That's got to be the question right now, Krepo. He's still on Gragas. He's still going to be really, really relevant for a bit. But it's hard for him to get involved in anything here because of the serious mobility that Lulex has because of how well Oduwane is doing. Honestly, the mid lane, I think that's his best bet right now. But Ryu is still on a very safe champion, Orianna.
Yeah, we've hit the 15-minute mark. Usually when we see H2K rally up for these objectives, zero dragons down so far. A couple of towers have fallen, two on the side of H2K, zero on the side of Elements, and the map pressure, as we said in Champ Select, leaning towards H2K, we're by no means an early game team, not the mid game.
Whoop. Froggen and Dexter are looking to make a desperate charge. Yharnam's there, and in from the backside comes JWoww as he gets a big gnar back. Kasing's going nowhere, but they invest a lot into this one. Let's see what they can get out of it. At least a dragon if they go for it, but they're backing in mass.
Smart move by Elements. They know they need a lot more number advantage to win these fights. They get a kill in the bot lane, but their top lane, that tower is under siege. Their mid lane tower is under siege. What will this play cost them? Can they stop the bleeding and somehow even up this gold?
They're going to need to act fast if H2K's previous games are any indicator. This point in the game, they start to get rolling pretty fast. So, tower going down bottom. Tabs will manage to take this one out, but unfortunately for Elements, Oduwane is still finishing off this tier two. 16 and a half minutes in, Krepo, and they've knocked down three, two in the top.
Yeah, mid lane tower looking to go down for H2K. Ryu arrives just in time for some wave clear. Kasing's looking for a hook. Teleport comes in.
Yeah, Oduwane is able to get in there and throw the equalizer down. Froggen burning away as he walks. Yharnam on the hunt. Kasing looking for a hook, looking to get in range. He's going to get the flay back on Promise Q. Prompt the monsoon. In comes the boomerang blade. And Promise Q, they're chasing him down. Spell shield. Yharnam has got the scent of blood in his eyes. Let's see if he can pick this kill. I think Promise Q's got very few places he can go. And Kasing will cut him off. Yharnam with another kill. Onto the support of Elements.
Yeah. Another check mark in the book for Oduwane. Takes down the kill on top lane. Two kills, three kills, one tower, two towers, teleports down, another tower. He is the man of this game and everything is centered around him. Every time he goes somewhere, action happens. And then after that action, in the wake of his plays, H2K get another gold lead, another 1,000 gold added to that pile.
And now the dragon. Elements had a chance to take it, but they panicked a little bit trying to defend turrets. They were able to defend the second tier mid, not so much the top. Meant the dragon was left open, and H2K will pick that one up, number one, and still defend this mid tower. How crazy is that?
Yeah, Ryu managed to keep the tower alive and well. Froggen's tower has fallen in the mid lane. And we see the CS, even Stevens in the mid lane. 156 for Ryu, 160 for Froggen's Kassadin.
In comes the Rek'Sai, Lulex. Onto Tabs, he's got a nice shield on from the Janna, but still, bold move. Oduwane flashing forward, that's gonna prompt an answer from some Elements members. Promise Q, he is way too squishy for this one. The Gnar Smash won't be nearly enough, and Oduwane 4-0 looking to add to that score as he throws down the equalizer. Lulex still on the chase, the barrel slowing, but not enough. Tabs has to flash away from the flame spinner. Big barrel comes out, JWoww's got no Gnar bar, and he's all alone. Goodbye, Oduwane with the fifth kill on the game.
Another offensive flash by Oduwane on his rumble, and I don't know, we'll have to see some bans against this champion next week because he's performing two games in a row fantastically.
What a play.
Absolutely fantastic. This rumble is oppressive, and Elements are feeling the burn time and time again. Gold lead now extended up to about 5,000 for H2K. We've not even hit 20 minutes on the board, Crepo, and they are showing that history repeats itself.
And poor JWoww stuck in that barbecue with the flame spitter, and even his teammates are getting grilled at the same time. Not the, quite the pleasant feeling Elements rather were looking for this game. It came in slow, steady. Again, not enough pressure, not enough lane push. They wanted the 2v2, got denied the 2v2 in the early game because of the way the early kills played out. Dexter found the opening, but it wasn't enough. And now, looking at almost a 5,000 gold lead for H2K.
Yeah, slow and steady does not win this race. H2K have found their advantage. They've found their edge. We'll see how far they can push it. For now, just keep your eyes on that man in the top lane wandering all over the map. Odawamne, he's got himself his Liandry's Torment. He's got his Sorc shoes on. He's looking ready to just walk all over this team.
Yeah, once this lineup from H2K starts getting ahead, it will be coming increasingly hard to kill them. We noticed the mobility on the Sivir, but we noticed the shield as well. Odawamne has a shield, Ryu has a shield, Kjarn has a spell shield, and then you have the Lantern Shield coming in as well, and Face of the Mountain finished on Kasing too. That's 5 or 6 shields that Elements will have to burn through, and they don't have this all-in potential. They have repetitive damage coming out, but every time their damage comes back up, a new shield will be prompted and ready by H2K, and Elements, they need an opening. Dexter managed to find one early. He had a little bit of group action a little later, but...
Seemed like his best bet was on mid, and we talked about it a lot, how it wasn't necessarily helping that JWoww was just not getting any attention. Finally, Dexter went there a few times, but Lulex was always in the picture. And as a result, he's just been farther and farther behind this game, but he's certainly not the only one. H2K now are able to grab the blue buff of Elements, not give them really anything to lean on this game. And you can see that they know every movement of Elements. Look at that jungle that they've got. It's lit up like a Christmas tree.
Yeah, completely lit up, and H2K, this is what they call like systematic destruction, step by step. Don't leave them any room to counter you. Deep vision, take away their jungle, take away their buffs, smite their wolves, get that little wolf spirit to walk around in the jungle. If you get flanked, you will get notification of that, and then slowly start hitting down those towers. You don't need to stress for these tier 2 towers just yet. Just keep controlling the game, keep snowballing that lead, and eventually pick up a Baron to snowball the game.
Elements can't do much too far from home.
He
right
wants
now.
To bait
Froggen, looking for Yharnam, spell shields on, but he's going to be forced to flash. His Ignite was ticking his health bar down. Tabs sent out the calling. Dexter, though, looking to make a play. Barrel's not going to be enough. It won't cover the distance, and Yharnam knows that he's got to get back to safety. But meanwhile, Odawamne and Ryu will be able to pick up a cross-map red buff.
Yeah, very interesting play there. Kasing wanted Froggen to jump out Yharnam, then eat the hook, go over, and punish Froggen, but then Once the hook missed, he panicked and wanted to throw his lantern over the wall, but just not quite far enough. Needs to lift a little more, toss that heavy lantern over. But Kjarn still had his flash. So
yeah, and he used it, so you know it helps Elements that he's not got that available. They know that that's not on the books, but there's so much mobility on this team anyways. You've got On the Hunt, you've got Lulex's Rek'Sai, and you know if they can get just a catch with Kasing, they can isolate people, but they don't even need to. They're still winning these skirmishes. They're still stronger in just about every aspect, and Dragon's gonna be up another minute and 20. They haven't really been a huge factor in this game so far, just sort of an afterthought for H2K, and Elements haven't even thought about it once.
Yeah, but what really strikes me in this game is the fact that Elements hasn't crossed the river in quite a long time. They've been stuck playing on their side of the map, contesting their own jungle. Meanwhile, H2K can always fall back, clear these extra camps, get a little more extra gold, and keep denying Elements of their resources and force them into very predictable plays.
Very defensive plays as well, but this time they're on the offense. Dexter is gonna throw out the barrel, but Ryu is getting back with the lantern. In comes a couple of teleports. JWoww not sure where to go as he's not got Meganar yet, but the rest of his team is burning away as Monsoon is on. Lulex and Odawamne in the back. They pick up tabs, looking for more. Odawamne gets a shield, and Lulex on the chase to try and finish the rest of Elements. So far, they picked up JWoww and tabs, and it looks like that'll be enough as they turn their attention upriver.
Odawamne teleports in the back. Equalizer does not connect, but somehow he managed to keep 4 people busy. Zonias is, you think, you had him written off. You thought he was dead. You thought it was a mistake, but he flashes out, and the quadruple shield comes in, keeps him alive. Somehow, H2K, fantastic play. Hook on Froggen.
Yep, and they know he's got a flash away from that one. Baron does not reset, but the barrel is on. Got to be careful of that 50-50 smite fight, and H2K will take the safety route, pick up the crab instead, and they will let elements push them away from the Baron.
Yeah, good flash by Ryu also in that fight. Managed to dodge the body slam coming over from Dexter. I think we'll see it again. Let's see it. Hook misses, goes wide. Righteous Glory gets popped. Ryu with the respect flash barely makes it out of that one. Then gets the lantern. Just comes in. Now let's keep an eye on the back. Odoama comes in, grills, taps immediately. Monsoon forced to be used defensively. Watch four people hovering around Odoama. They want that kill streak bonus, but he flashes out one shield, two shields, three shields, and a heal. Yeah. Not enough, no targeted lockdown. We said this before. Elements, the only hard CC that they really have is the ER combo from Dexter, but that was already used then. H2K poised. Take this Baron.
Part two. Tabs is there, but not much of anyone else. Dexter could potentially roll in the barrel, flash in for a smite attempt.
He's got
the barrel on. He's got to try this. This is a desperation attempt. He goes forward, but he's not got the timer on it. Secured up by Ryu. Down goes Dexter, and the five-man squad of H2K have a window here to make something happen.
Incredibly risky play by H2K. Not sure if I like it, but it worked out in the end, so obviously they had the right idea. Hindsight is always 20-20.
Yeah, if the play works, it was always a good play, Kreppo. So with that, Baron now secured by H2K. They are all up in Elements jungle, looking to start knocking down some towers. They could take a dragon if they wanted, but forget the dragon. We got super minions, or rather Baron-empowered minions. Maybe super minions are on the way. As tower in the bottom gets taken down, Elements trying to look for a flank, but I don't think they'll be able to find one big enough.
Yeah, and very little wave there on the side of Elements.
Big, big equalizer just to zone them all off. Inhibitor turrets. H2K have come a knocking, and Elements do not want to open the door. But what choice do they have right now? H2K will grab the inhibitor with little to no resistance. Yharnam on the hunt, spell shield. Froggen looking to come in onto Kasing. A hook does not connect. Froggen, however, just doesn't have any way to re-engage. Blue buff on the way out. Why, thank you. We'll take it. And on to the dragon. H2K strangling Elements and taking away everything from them.
Yeah, and if there weren't enough shields already, Gulex finished his locket quite a while ago. Another shield added to that, and Elements will have a hard time target prioritizing rather. Kasing is the likely only target that will fall. Maybe we'll see the revenge kill here, but
they have got to deal with Odoamne. This guy is just too big, but the rest of the team is playing quite well on top of it. Elements try a quick push in the mid, but nothing comes of it as H2K make use of their Baron to push the minions back and to prevent Elements from going any further in this game. Now Lulex, he's going for a little bit of split push action up on the top side. Let's see if Elements can react. The backs have been stopped for now.
Yeah, I really like that. He still has about a minute left on his Baron buff, so he can split push top lane, push that in. Not sure if you could go for these golems here, but
sometimes you gotta krug it up.
Sometimes you gotta krug it up, indeed, Pyra. Get that little extra gold. Buff those creeps again, and look at that massive top wave. He's buying time, that's why he went for the Krugs. He didn't want to instantly push that wave, because he wanted H2K with the remaining four members to push in mid lane, go for the solid 4-1 push, knock on two doors at once, and we saw Elements, they couldn't do it when they were knocking on one door, let alone two.
Yeah, well, now it's Elements have to secure all facets of their base, but another inhibitor turret's about to go down. In comes the Meganar. Big Gnar against the wall, but he's not going to be able to do much more. That's a Meganar, and his health bar is evaporating. Odoamne, Lulex in the front line. Dexter, the barrel, Froggen, he's going down, pulled back in by the shockwave as Odoamne's still alive in all this. Meganar is going down as soon as he transforms. Promiscue, he's not going to the right base, and now the Nexus turrets are going down. The only member alive from Elements is their support, and I'm not sure what one get Janna can do against so many. Another Nexus turret going down. H2K finally will secure the ace. The Nexus is bare, and a methodical and surgical dismantling of Elements is completed.
Systematic destruction coming out from H2K with the chief surgeon on duty being Odoamne. Fantastic play on that rumble yet again. Fanworthy.
Absolutely. At this point, if you're any of H2K's opponents, you have to start considering that. And I don't know what kind of surgeon uses a flame spitter, but pretty darn scary one.
Desperate times.
Yeah.
Call for desperate measures.
Indeed they do. You look across the board, though. Everyone on H2K played, I would say very well, solid. If not extremely well, this game. Solid is a good way to put it. Elements, individual performances were not terrible. JWoww had a really rough start. He never got rolling. As a result, H2K didn't really need to respect his Gnar. He got a couple of big combos off, but nothing came of it.
And again, I think the problem for Elements and the root of all their evil lies in their drafting phase. I really feel they should start incorporating what they call pressure into their drafts, because Froggen, yes, he can survive that lane against Orianna. No, he won't get bursted, but he loses the push. So that's mid lane pushed in already. JWoww, he got pushed the entire game. Oduwamna had full control of that lane. Let's go back to the early game where Oduwamna was freezing, denying the first bits of CS, snowballing from that point onwards, and Habs and Promiscue couldn't do enough. Good opening by Dexter early, but just wasn't enough. He only has two barrels.
Yeah. He can only throw so many, and you know, at the end of the day, that just wasn't enough to really save the game. I think he tried to help JWoww a little bit more this game. We talked about that and how that was a downfall of them in their previous game yesterday, but this time around, I'd say a very different way to get beat. It was just H2K doing what they do. Take the lead mid-game, they never let go.
And their signature draft as well, a beautiful composition. Playing to their strengths. I like it when teams recognize what works for them and then they draft accordingly. We have the Rumble, Rek'Sai, Orianna, Sivir, Thresh as a combination, and I like it. It was solid, executed, played around their weaknesses, played around their strengths, and fantastic game by H2K, and yet again, Oduwamna.
That's a team that's always ready to rumble now. So we're going to go ahead and go side stage where Quickshot is standing.